Hi everyone. In this video, let us discuss the new generation benzodiazepine Remimazolam. So what is this drug Remimazolam? If we carefully observe, this drug is having the suffix azolam, which indicates that this drug is a benzodiazepine. Just like other drugs such as midazolam, trizolam, this drug is having the similar suffix azolam, indicating that it is a benzodiazepine with fused ring system. So Remimazolam is a fused benzodiazepine, and this drug is considered as soft drug. Remimazolam is given by IV route, so it is having quick onset of action, but this drug is available as ester form, which is going to be hydrolyzed to produce carboxylic acid. The ester is the active form of this drug, whereas carboxylic acid is somewhat inactive form of this drug. That's why Remimazolam is short acting with duration of action less than 30 minutes. So Remimazolam is a ultra short acting benzodiazepine indicated for induction as well as maintenance of sedation for short surgical procedures. So in those surgical procedures where sedation is required for less than 30 minutes, Remimazolam can be given by IV route for both induction as well as maintenance of sedation. So today in this video, we are going to discuss how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, it is the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of Remimazolam. You can clearly observe it is having the benzodiazepine ring, which is fused with imidazole ring. And here we can observe the ester functionality. So let us give the numbering. So this is 1, 2 and 3. This ester is essential for activity. If it is hydrolyzed, it produces a carboxylic acid, which is somewhat inactive. Now, if we write the IUPAC name for this compound, simply it is the methyl propionate derivative. At the third position, it is having this entire ring, so we can write this as 3-. So, what is the name of this ring? So, we can start the numbering from this carbon. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In this way, we can complete the numbering to this fused benzodiazepine ring system. Now, what is the name of this ring system? It is simply 1,4-benzodiazepine, which is attached by fourth position. So, we can write this as 1,4-benzodiazepine 4-aryl. And this 1,4-benzodiazepine is fused with imidazole by first and second position to the A side of benzodiazepine. So, we can write this as imidazole 1,2-A. Then, we can identify what are the other groups attached to this ring system. Eighth position, bromine is present. So, 8-bromo. First position methyl group is present, and sixth position pyridine ring is attached by second position. So 6-pyridine-2-aryl. And finally, saturation is present at fourth position. So 4-H. That is a complete name of Remimazole. So Remimazole is a fused benzodiazepine with ester functionality, which can be easily hydrolyzed to produce free carboxylic acid, resulting in the loss of activity. That's why this drug is having short duration of action, and it is classified as ultra short acting benzodiazepine with duration of action less than 30 minutes. Now let us see how this drug acts. Remimazolam mainly acts on the GABA A receptors, which are ionotropic receptors coupled with chloride channels. On these GABA A receptors, GABA can act to produce the hyperpolarization, but the action of GABA is more facilitated in presence of Remimazolam. So this drug can bind to the GABA A receptors in between the alpha and gamma binding site, which facilitates the binding of GABA. Now GABA can more bind to GABA A receptors in between alpha and beta subunits. This results in the opening of chloride channels, leading to increased negative potential within the membrane, resulting in hyperpolarization. So this hyperpolarization produces an inhibitory response, which reduces the neuronal activity. Finally, it induces sedation within the patients. In this way, Remimazolam can be used to induce a sedation for short-term surgical procedures less than 30 minutes. What are the precautions of this drug? Remimazolam, when it is given during the induction, we can observe few of the symptoms in the patients. The heart rate may be reduced, resulting in the bradycardia. And even the oxygen levels are going to be reduced, resulting in hypoxia. Even a sudden fall in the blood pressure can also be observed in the patients. So all these things should be closely monitored when this Remimazolam is given by IV route. That's why during the recovery, the oxygen supply should be maintained in order to reduce the hypoxia produced in the patients. And whenever required, the flumazenil should be available, because this drug can antagonize the remimazolam so that it can reduce the toxic effects of this drug. Similarly, this drug can also increase the hypersensitivity within the patient, so it can produce some skin rashes, urticaria and pruritus. So if any hypersensitive reactions are observed, then this drug should be avoided. This drug should be carefully given in the pregnant woman, as it may produce neonatal sedation and respiratory depression. So in the pregnant woman with later stages of pregnancy, this drug should be carefully given. Even within the children, this drug should be carefully given. So remimazolam can reduce the neuronal activity and it can produce some neurotoxicity within the patients. So in the children, we can observe unexpected neurotoxicity, which should be avoided. So in the pediatric patients, this drug should be carefully given. What are the side effects? The important side effects of this drug mainly include hypotension, the decrease in the blood pressure, which is observed during the induction as well as recovery. And it can also produce some bradycardia, hypoxia, and sometimes it can also fluctuate the blood pressure, resulting in hypertension. Even it can also increase the heart rate, resulting in tachycardia. And it can also produce some upper respiratory tract infections, resulting in cough, pharyngitis. So a sensitive balance is maintained during the induction and recovery of this drug. At a toxic dose, it reduces the blood pressure, but suddenly it can also increase the blood pressure, and it reduces the heart rate, and it can also increase the heart rate. So any of these fluctuations can be observed with use of this drug. So this drug should be carefully used to induce the sedation, and any toxic effects can be counteracted by injection of flumazenil, which is the benzodiazepine antagonist. How it is given? Remimazole is available as IV solution. It is also available as dry powder, which can be used by reconstitution. For induction of sedation, this drug can be given at a dose range of 2.5 to 5 mg, given for 1 minute. And for the maintenance, it is given at 2.5 mg, given within 15 seconds. So that's about this drug remimazolam, which is a ultra short acting benzodiazepine. This drug is having the ester functionality, which can be easily hydrolyzed to produce the free carboxylic acid, which is the inactive metabolite of this drug. Because of rapid metabolism, this drug is having a short duration of action with less than 30 minutes. So that's why it is classified as ultra short acting benzodiazepine. This drug is indicated for induction as well as maintenance of sedation for short surgical procedures less than 30 minutes. But during the induction and recovery, it can produce some hypotension, bradycardia and hypoxia. And sometimes it can also produce hypertension and tachycardia, which should be closely monitored. When it is given to the pregnant woman, it can produce some neonatal side effects, resulting in the neonatal sedation and respiratory depression. Within the children, this drug can produce some neurotoxicity. So care should be taken when this drug is indicated for pregnant women as well as in the children. So that's about this drug, remimazolam. That's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.